together of Amanda Gail Petty and Jesse Cole Gamble in holy matrimony. Holy matrimony in that it is the joining together of the lives of two believers in Christ into one life. We also say it's holy matrimony because it is God who has established and sanctified marriage for His glory. Marriage is instituted by God. It's regulated by His commands. According to Hebrews 13:4, to be held in honor by all, and it is blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ. Genesis 2:24 says, "For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we bow before You this evening, and we just ask Your blessing upon this ceremony. Lord, this ceremony that marks the beginning of their life together. We pray a blessing on all that are here to witness and to just rejoice in this time. We ask these things in Christ's name. Amen. Who blesses this marriage and gives this bride? You may be seated. It is Christ of whom the Apostle Paul speaks in Colossians 1:16-17, saying, "For by Him all things were created, all things have been created through Him and for Him, and in Him all things hold together." Marriage has been created through Christ for His glory. It is in Christ that a marriage truly holds together. And while the Bible gives us no set guidelines as to how to exactly conduct a wedding ceremony, through the Apostle Paul's writings, inspired by the Holy Spirit, it does speak of the type of love that should be displayed in a marriage, as well as the responsibilities of marriage. The type of love is found in 1 Corinthians 13:4-7, which says, "Love is patient, love is kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It's not irritable. It keeps no record of wrongdoing. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance." It's easy to see that great blessings would come with so great a love. However, such a love comes with responsibilities. And Paul speaks of those in Ephesians 5:21-33. "And further, submit one another to one another out of reverence for Christ. For wives, this means submit to your husbands as to the Lord. For a husband is head of the wife, as Christ is head of the church. He is the Savior of his body, the church. As the church submits to Christ, so your wives should submit to your husbands in everything. For husbands, this means love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave up his life for her to make her holy and clean, washed by the cleansing of God's word. He did this to present her to himself as a glorious church without spot or wrinkle or any other blemish. Instead, she will be holy and without fault. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as they love their own bodies, for a man who loves his wife actually shows love for himself. No one hates his own body, but feeds and cares for it, just as Christ cares for the church. And we are members of his body. As the scriptures say, a man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife, and the two are united into one. This is a great mystery, but it is an illustration of the way Christ and the church are one. So again, I say, each man must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband." A whole lot about responsibilities of marriage in that, and it seems like a lot of it hinges on this whole thing of wives submit. Amanda, I've had a lot of young brides kind of question that and go, "Why is it me submitting and it doesn't say anything about him?" Although the preference starts where it says, "Submit therefore one to another," in the very first of those verses. But let me explain exactly to you and all the other wives and wives-to-be what Paul is saying in this passage. He says, "Wives, you should love and follow your husbands just as Christ's bride, the church, is to love and follow him. And husbands, You should love and lead your brides just as Christ loves and leads his bride, the church. Now do that, Jesse. Do that, gentlemen. We as men need to know and understand just the type of leadership Christ displayed when he was here on earth. In order to model the same Christ-like leadership, we need to understand it was that of servant leader. The night of the Last Supper, we know that story. Jesus was the first to pick up a towel and a water basin and begin washing feet that night. And as far as we know, the only one to have left the room without having had his feet washed. So what he was doing there, on the most trying night of his life, he put aside his own comfort and his own wants and desires for that of those he loved, for his bride. So Jesse, just as I said to all the other young grooms, I've had the privilege and the honor of conducting their wedding ceremony, I'll say to you, if you ever look over your shoulder and you see Amanda not following, check first your leadership. Are you leading her with servant leadership? If you lead her with Christ-like servant leadership, as long as Amanda is striving to be the godly woman that God has called her to be, she'll follow you in whatever the Lord has for you both. It'll greatly bless your marriage. Jesse, do you take Amanda to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Amanda, do you take Jesse to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
The ring is a symbol of the marriage seal in two ways. First, the purity of the gold. It symbolizes the purity of your love for each other. Also, the unending circle represents, it symbolizes the unending vows that you're making today. Vows that may be broken honorably in the sight of God only by death. So guess who's home. I, Jesse, take you, Amanda, to be my wife.
I, Jesse, take you, Amanda, to be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part. I, Amanda, take you, Jesse, to be my husband.
I, Amanda, take you, Jesse, to be my husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
At this time, Jesse and Amanda have chosen to take part in the ceremony of the tying of God's knot. This represents the joining together of two lives together being bound by God.
I praise thee, I am, and watch us where we go, and help us to be wise. Times that we don't know. Let this be our prayer. When we lose our way, lead us to the place that is with your grace. To a place where we be safe. La luce que
brilla. We see the tying of God's knot reflected in the scriptures. Ecclesiastes 4:12, we It says, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. And Jesus said in Matthew 19:6, so they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. Colossians 3:12-17 offer words of encouragement and direction for the relationships of all Christians, but it's encouragement and direction that can and should be applied to marriage. Since God chose you to be the holy people He loves, you must clothe yourselves with tender-hearted mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Make allowance for each other's faults and forgive anyone who offends you. Remember, the Lord forgave you, so you must forgive each other. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds us all together in perfect harmony. And let the peace that comes from Christ rule in your hearts. For as members of one body, you are called to live in peace and always be faithful. Let the message about Christ and all its richness fill your lives. Teach and counsel each other with all wisdom. Sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs to God and with thankful hearts. And whatever you do or say, do it as a representative of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks through Him to God the Father. What incredible advice. Apply those words to your marriage daily, and you'll receive many great blessings in your relationship together. Proverbs 3:3 says, let love and faithfulness never leave you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart. Just as we've seen symbolism in the rings and in the tying of the knot, the symbolism there, but binding them around your heart is much like a necklace adds to the dress or the gown, the outfit. So let love and faithfulness decorate, so to speak, your marriage and your relationship. The other one, it says, write them on the tablet of your heart. Tablets in the Old Testament were made of stone. And so an inscription was a permanent one in nature. So today, you're not making writings or scribblings on in the sand of a beach. They can be washed away with the first wave of trouble or disagreement. But you're making a permanent inscription on the tablet of your hearts. Well, Jesse, I've known you for a long time. A long, long time. But I've watched you grow from this little boy who ended up in middle school in our youth group, who would be the one who would torment my bride as she tried to teach Sunday school classes, to actually becoming a leader in that youth group. I watched you go from pulling pranks at youth fundraisers to being the go-to guy when we needed to get something done and settling the younger kids down. From fighting for the back seat on the van so you could just veg out with your headphones on before leaving for summer camp, to actually riding shotgun with me in the van so you could listen to classic rock stations with me and we'd play Name That Group. Remember that? I was very proud, actually. And that in mind, that thing about singing psalms, you might want to just have him hum. Jesse, I watched as you entered the Navy and served with distinction, being an honor to your country, the Navy, your family, and your Lord. And I watched from afar as you made all the sacrifices it takes to work your way through college. And what I've noticed in each of these phases of your life, I've noticed you approach and you make it through each phase in the same fashion. Others may see other things, but what I see each time is eyes wide open, joyous heart, always that mischievous streak, yeah, but also determined, dedicated, and faithful. You've been successful in each of those phases. So I have no doubt, as you and Amanda enter into this next phase of your life, applying that same fashion, you guys will be successful in marriage. So I say to both of you, Godspeed. Well, inasmuch as you have made these vows today, before all these witnesses, to each other and to Almighty God, by the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ, I pronounce you husband and wife. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God the Father, and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always. Jesse, you may kiss your bride. It is my great honor and privilege to introduce for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Jesse Cole Gamble.
Charade that doesn't seem to be a reason to change. You know, I feel so dirty when they start talking cute. Wanna tell her that I love her, but the point is probably moot. Cause she's watching them with those eyes, and she's loving them with that body. I just know it. And he's holding her in his arms late night. You know, I wish that I had Jesse's girl.
For those of you who don't know me, I am Amanda's younger sister. So for days I've been thinking of all memories that I have, and the one that's her particular favorite is when I was little and she was an infant, and for some reason my mother thought it would be a good idea for me to push her around in a carriage. And then I dropped her. Well, obviously it did some good because she is, I knocked some sense into her because she has turned out to be an amazing, smart, and beautiful young lady who I love dearly. And if you would have told me that this very mature woman has met the man she loves in a bar, I would not have believed it. But I guess there are good men in bars. So, but we want to welcome Jesse and the rest of his family to our family, and we adore them both, and I love you both dearly.
Hello, how's everyone doing tonight? Everything all right? Good. Awesome.
Woo!
Well, I have known Jesse for a long time, since kindergarten, pretty much, something like that. Well, he is my brother from a different mother. And I just want to say congratulations, Amanda. You're always welcome, and my family as well. He's my family, whatever. That's great. But Jesse, love you, brother. Amanda, love you, sister. Congratulations.
Give it up for Mikey D right here. Come up on the floor. What? Can I get an amen over here?
Amen.
Can I get an amen over there?
Amen.
I say, can I get an amen from everybody?
Amen.
How's everybody doing today? I'm Jesse, brother. I'm also the man
floor that does spins very well, in case you did not notice. First off, I want to congratulate the both of them for completing their schooling, and you're still going through that, I know, Amanda.
One day.
You'll get there one day, right? I think we need to congratulate them on that right now. Everybody. I don't really know Amanda that well. I don't know where to go from here. But I love you to death. I do. You look beautiful today, too. I'm hoping in the future we're all closer together as a family. I'm glad to have you in my life. You're all right.
Yeah.
I've treated Jesse when I was a kid like hell. I beat the hell out of him. I'm not going to lie. But he turned out pretty good. I like to think I was throwing 100-mile-an-hour fastballs, but they were probably 45. And I used to make him get crouched down and just aim for his head. Sometimes they would hit, sometimes they'd miss. But he turned out really good, and I'm really proud of him. I'm proud of him going to the Navy and everything. I'm proud of Amanda following her dreams and the two finding each other. So I'd like everybody to raise their glasses. Let's salute Jesse and Amanda. Yeah, Mel. Salute.
Amanda has been my best friend since we were four. We practically lived together most of our childhood and even some during college. We did everything together. We had all the same toys, shared most things, fought over a few things. Think alike on many things. Often found ourselves saying the same thing at the same time. Wore pretty much the same thing without planning ahead. We've always shared our joys and our hurts, and it's with so much joy in my heart for her and Jesse that, and with slight mixed emotion, that I have to say she's found a new best friend. And I wish them a lifetime of joy and being so close that they think the same things and say the same things, and a lifetime of sharing everything, fighting over a few things, but probably never wearing the same things. So here's to Amanda and Jesse, and best friends forever.
Yes, and a queen, she's ruined me all night long. always got to go.